I'm sure you've all seen the video. It's Richard Dawkins in an orange jumpsuit with a dead giraffe on National Geographic. What could go wrong? Well, apparently quite a lot. In this now famous instance, Dawkins argues that the course of the left recurrent laryngeal nerve in the giraffe provides evidence that God doesn't exist. Why? Because if a designer was really behind evolution, then he has to be pretty stupid to have the nerve travel all the way down the neck, looping around the arch of the aorta, before coming back up to the larynx, the voice box. In the giraffe, what should have been a direct connection between the brain and the larynx actually takes meters of detour. Confused? Here's the National Geographic anatomist explaining the journey.
What I'm actually holding here is the beginning of that nerve. It actually starts out not as a separate nerve, but as a branch coming off of a bigger nerve called the vagus nerve. And this is going to keep running all the way down the body. And this is going to wrap around the great vessels coming out of the heart. So here it is wrapping around that, and then it continues right there. So here's the vagus going down, and here's the vagus continuing.
Right.
And right over here, there's a branch right there. So it's looping and it's coming back. It's doing a U-turn all the way down here. So it's traveled that entire distance to make a U-turn to go all the way back up again. And so now we could follow it going back up again. And if we look, we see it again over here. Here it is. This is the voice box, the larynx. And so you can see it going right into the back of the larynx here. So this is a very important nerve. Interestingly, where it ends is pretty close to where it started. It started here, coming out of the brain. It really only needed to go about 2 inches.
Yes, amazing.
But it went all the way down and came all the way back.
Yes. That's a beautiful example of historical legacy as opposed to design.
Exactly. This is not an intelligent design. An intelligent design would be to go from here to here.
Yes.
Dawkins argues that it is like this because in fish, the ancestors of the giraffe, the nerve makes a similar but much shorter journey that makes sense in fish. Dawkins uses this step-by-step elongation of the nerve as evidence of the power of mutation and natural selection to achieve functionality through a gradual process. But is Dawkins right? Is the course of this nerve all the way down the neck simply an artifact of evolution, providing no benefit to the organism? Sadly for Dawkins, he couldn't be more wrong. And it's sad that the National Geographic gave him a platform for the spread of such misinformation. In fact, the recurrent laryngeal nerve, far from being an argument against a designer, is a fantastic example of design. Indeed, it is a great test case as to whether Dawkins' atheistic framework of evolution is true or not. You see, the recurrent laryngeal nerves are one of two sets of nerves that supply the voice box. The superior laryngeal nerve does actually travel straight from the brain to the voice box without any detour. So the question he should have asked is, why do the recurrent laryngeal nerves take this seemingly circuitous route? Is it doing anything on its journey to and from the voice box? The answer is a resounding yes. The recurrent laryngeal nerves are mixed nerves. This means that they carry motor impulses to organs as well as taking sensory inputs from organs. So although they travel to the larynx, they connect with a whole host of different organs, such as the esophagus, the aorta, the heart, and the lungs. They sound like pretty important functions to me. Gray's Anatomy, the most famous anatomical textbook in the world, puts it like this. As the recurrent nerve hooks around the subclavian artery or aorta, it gives off several cardiac filaments to the deep part of the cardiac plexus. As it ascends in the neck, it gives off branches more numerous on the left than on the right side to the mucous membrane and muscular coat of the esophagus, branches to the mucous membrane and muscular fibers of the trachea, and some pharyngeal filaments to the constrictor pharyngis inferior. We know this is true from a medical perspective, because damage to these nerves results in a host of problems relating to swallowing. But perhaps Dawkins doesn't think swallowing food is that important for an organism. The standout feature of Dawkins is not his anatomical error, but the stunning arrogance and certainty with which he states his error. If he had taken a pinch of humility and approached the matter as a scientist should do, gathering facts, making relevant investigations, then this video of ours at Rational Religion would probably never have been necessary. That's all for today. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell for notifications when we drop a new video. And visit rationalreligion.co.uk for more content. Peace be on you.